Billingham is a small town, but one of the most up-to-date in the country. Its population of 35,000 live in modern houses and flats close to an exciting new town centre. Here, the go-ahead people of Billingham can shop in safety. They can walk on heated pavements, or maybe sample the high cuisine of modern restaurants. There's even a nightclub. Nothing, it seems, has been left out of this comprehensive scheme, for at the East End is a super kind of recreational club. It's called the Forum, and was created by a council who have recognised that a modern community needs more than just shops and houses. Inside, you can go swimming or ice skating, play squash or bowls, visit the theatre, and a whole lot more besides. It was officially opened on October the 19th, 1967, by Her Majesty the Queen. First, she met the local councillors and other leading figures from the local authorities and industries. Then came the unveiling of Bainbridge Copnall's sculpture. It depicts the unity of the people, particularly that of the family, and underlines the town's motto of faith, faith in the younger generation. At the entrance to the Forum, Her Majesty met the director, Geoffrey Bott. From his office, just above, he's the man in charge of day-to-day running of the centre. Mr. Alan Ward was next to be introduced. He's the architect responsible for the whole project. Third in line is Mr. Shepherd, managing director of the main contractors. Throughout the visit, the Queen was accompanied by the chairman of the council, Douglas Turnbull. Work began on the centre in the summer of 1965. Basically, it's four separate buildings linked together by general amenity areas. The four main units are the swimming pool, ice rink, theatre and sports centre. The theatre is the only major unit which doesn't have a steel frame construction. Instead, load-bearing brickwork is used because its mass helps in the reduction of sound transmission. Within 6 months, the basic framework was complete. And in the case of the ice rink, the roof structure is unique in this country. It's based on two interconnected, high-tensile rope trusses, each braced with diagonal ties. Inclined arches take the forces from the cables, and these forces are transmitted to the ground through four raking columns, held apart at the feet by compression beams. The inclined columns support the arch beams, and these were erected in sections which were then site welded together. The roof is supported by cable trusses, a system evolved in Sweden by David Yarworth and erected by British Ropes. The complete trusses were prefabricated on the ground, including the diagonal braces. Each cable truss was lifted into position by a crane and attached to the arch beams by a large nut and bolt. Obtaining the correct design stress was very important. The rope trusses were tensioned to this predetermined stress by using an annular jack and tightening the end of each cable in turn. Finally, the trusses were tuned to the correct pitch. For the roof covering, a light metal decking is used, which spans between the cable trusses. Just 26 months since the work was begun, and now it's all complete. The finished roof is designed to deflect 2 foot 5 inches from maximum wind load to full snow load. The ice area is 180 by 80 feet, big enough for ice hockey. But unlike most rinks, this one is also designed to be used as a major games area. For example, professional tennis tournaments have been held here. The swimming pool is national size, 110 by 42 feet. It's 11 feet 6 inches deep at the diving end and has 1 and 3 meter springboards. A feature of the design is the restrained use of windows in order to cut down on the amount of glare and reflection. There's a small learner's pool too. Maximum depth here is 3 feet. The low ceiling and the clear separation from the main pool gives learners an extra touch of encouraging privacy. Both pools use the new top deck system. Water comes to the level of the surround. No need for a scum trough or handrail. The refreshment area on the first floor has on one side a coffee bar and on the other a first-class restaurant. This is the main hall of the general sports area. It provides enough space for 4 badminton courts. And a variety of games, such as basketball and netball, can all be played to full county standards. Nearby is this long room, used for archery. Normally, practice spotlights only are used over the targets. The floor is a composition of asphalt with cork and rubber aggregate. The room can quickly be adapted for golf practice, small ball shooting, and cricket. Upstairs is a small hall, and here, in addition to table tennis, there's judo, boxing, and so on. There's hardly a sport which isn't catered for at the forum. Here, on a special carpet, Indoor bowls is a game which can be enjoyed by young and old alike. Squash, one of the fastest growing sports at the moment. In the Billingham Forum, there are three courts and good spectator viewing facilities. After a fast and furious game, this communal activity is very welcome. The bar overlooks the inner courtyard, and so does the creche below it. For annual members, there's no charge. Families are very much encouraged to use the centre, and a family membership is good for both husband and wife, and any number of children under 15. From the foyer, spectators are soon separated from participants. Everyone taking part in any of the activities finds the entrance at the ground level, whereas the communal viewing and refreshment areas are nearly all on the first floor. Families are encouraged to use the theatre too. The boxes were designed with the idea of a family night out. In all, 650 people can be entertained here. There's no doubt that the objects of the forum are being achieved. Every day, from 9 in the morning until 11 at night, there's something for all the family to enjoy. Of course, it attracts people from a much wider area than Billingham itself. About 20 to 25,000 people are using it every week. And for them, this public meeting place is fulfilling an important need.